This video is just a short version of a longer, very technical video I posted today on my channel. And the topic is simple. The Samsung S20 Ultra is promoting its space zoom. And space zoom means you should be able to photograph the moon with its 100 times magnification. But the problem is the S20 Ultra can see the moon with its fantastic hardware, but it cannot take photos of the moon. That's what this little video is about. If you have seen the longer version, you don't need to see this. Let's get started. The Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra has a 4x optical zoom, a 10x hybrid zoom, and 100x magnification all in. And with what Samsung calls the space zoom, you should be able to photograph the moon. And what I'm showing here is a 30x magnification, pointing the smartphone at the moon and catching information onto the camera sensor through the lens. This is the telescope lens here, or the telezoom lens, with 103mm focal length on a 35mm full frame equivalent. And you see that the smartphone, with its fantastic hardware, is very well capable of capturing the structure of the moon in the way it should be. And on my channel, there are various videos from more than a year ago where I showed how to zoom the moon with the Huawei P30 Pro. And I think the S20 Ultra is at par with what we are seeing here. It's a fantastic hardware, and we can go beyond that. Let's go beyond 50 times here to get the moon even closer. And by the way, it gets a quite challenge for my tripod here. Every little movement of the smartphone is creating vibrations, so I apologize if this is a bit shaky, but you see and get the scene here. The moon structure is very nicely captured through the lenses, and I should say through the lens here, because it's the telezoom lens of the Samsung S20 Ultra. The problem is you have no RAW option here, and Samsung is ruining every shot you do in extreme magnification situations here. And I'm going to show that in a moment. And that's a pity, because if people talk about a space zoom, you should be able, with 100x magnification, to get a nice image of the moon, because that's one of the minimum requirements I personally would impose on a smartphone which claims to have space zoom. And going now beyond 80x magnification here, it gets even more challenging with the tripod to keep it sturdy, but I try my best, so apologies for the shaky situation here. But again, you see the structure of the moon very nicely, and it's amazing that a smartphone can get so close to the moon and you get basically on the full frame a very nice structural image of the moon in the way we see it coming from professional DSLMs and DSLR. Reducing brightness will typically enhance the impression here and get an even better image of the moon. But as I said, the problem with the S20 Ultra, and that's the big mistake Samsung is doing here with its smartphone software, it ruins the image. So here you see a JPEG as it comes out. As I said, the RAW option is not available at high magnification zooms here. And the RAW image looks like an oil painting, and it gets worse and worse the larger the magnification is. You have a hard time seeing any structure here which you saw before through the lens via screen recording in that demonstration I made, but the JPEG you get out of the camera is just not usable. And this is looking like an oil painting, but not like an image of the moon. I would love if Samsung would improve their camera software. I would love if they would stop softening and smoothing and washing out JPEG images. The S20 Ultra has a lot of potential. You see here a shot taken in the night mode of the smartphone. And there is so much good stuff about that hardware. And if you don't have the RAW option, you have to rely on the JPEG. But if the JPEG is aggressively smooth, you lose all that information the camera sensors are able to capture through the lens, which you can prove by doing a screen recording, but then taking the shot, the JPEG is just ruined. If you like my video, please give me a thumbs up. If you like my channel, please subscribe. If you're interested in the technical background of what's going on here, please watch my long video. The link is posted below in the info box. Thanks for watching, and peace out.